Aristotle is quoted as saying, the more you know, the more you don't know. And it's that sentiment that I think draws me to science. The frontiers of science are constantly creating and bursting knowledge bubbles, growing what we know and expanding what we don't know. Dark physics is physics we don't know, physics that is yet to be explained, physics that there is evidence for, but the evidence is the evidence is there. This is the Milky Way galaxy, and Aristotle would have seen it easily. Unfortunately, today's light pollution makes it nearly impossible for us to observe this. But Aristotle knew that we were a part of a much larger structure, a much larger universe. And thanks to fairly simple telescopic technology, we now know that the Milky Way galaxy has 100 billion stars in it, of which we are just one solar system, 100 billion stars. Thanks to other technology, we now know that the stars of our galaxy are simply one of many. The Hubble telescope is capable of viewing much deeper into our universe. If you were to take a grain of rice and hold it at arm's length at the black sky, somewhere at night where you could not see a single star, this would be what you could see if you zoomed in far enough. This image contains 10,000 galaxies, each of which contain 100 billion stars, roughly, just like ours. It's that knowledge that has drawn scientists to understand our universe on a deeper level. And through other technologies, we've been able to scan the entire universe. This is referred to as the microwave background of our universe. It's essentially the light from the origination of the Big Bang reflecting off the boundary of our universe and coming back. The distance across is measured as 5.5 million, 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 million miles, or 93 billion light years. It's an immense size. It's unimaginable under most conditions. But what's remarkable about this structure is that this image shows a temperature gradient, difference in energy of the boundaries of our universe. The difference between red and blue is 3 degrees Kelvin, which means that on the largest, most zoomed out scale, our universe is nearly uniform when you look at it, almost smooth, as it were. And this fact is a remarkable fact and has yet to have any true explanation as to how this could be so perfectly uniform. One such explanation comes from something that was actually discovered through a separate experiment, separate observations that had nothing to do with that particular thought. It's called dark matter. Dark matter is affected by gravity, but it's only affected by gravity, which means we cannot see it, we cannot measure it, we cannot detect it in any traditional sense, save for its gravitational effects. However, by studying its gravitational effects, we now know that the universe has 10 times the matter that we traditionally interact with. This immense mass spread evenly throughout our universe is one possible explanation as to why this structure is so uniform. Furthermore, since gravity is a unique force in the sense that it is an attraction of matter only, gravity pulls matter together. It forms structure. It pulls stars together. It creates planets. It creates galaxies. It slows the energy as it spreads out. And so in 1994, a team of scientists set out to measure the rate at which this expansion was slowing down. The idea being, of course, to predict when the universe would stop expanding. And of course, They would have been awarded the prize simply for measuring that rate and determining the value. But to their surprise, and to all scientists' surprise, they actually discovered that the acceleration rate is increasing faster today than it has ever been in the universe lifetime. This means that it is energetically expanding instead of slowing down and forming structure. This is a remarkable and unexplainable phenomenon. And to explain it is, well, first of all, I'm sorry, the picture of our universe now looks like this, an accelerating universe that is expanding faster and faster every day, so that sometime, well beyond our time on our planet, there will come a day where the Hubble telescope will not be able to see those 10,000 galaxies. Not because they're not there, but because they are so far away that the light will never reach our planet. Given that fact, there must be some thing that is causing this acceleration. That acceleration is described currently as dark energy. And dark energy is even stranger than dark matter, mainly because we have no real proof, evidence, or observation besides that one fact that I just told you that is making this occur. And so that is what is currently being researched by scientists at the frontier of physics. To do that research, humans have built this device. It's called the Large Hadron Collider. The Large Hadron Collider, the LHC, is the largest man-made machine ever. It is a 17-mile circumference device that is 500 feet buried underground. It is essentially an enormous electromagnet with two main detectors that are beyond scope in size, where they accelerate protons to nearly the speed of light, smash them together, and detect the particles that come out. They catalog these particles in basically an internet unto itself in order to identify particles that we have yet to identify. This structure combines a thousand scientists from 35 countries researching in multi-disciplines of science, physics, engineering, computer science, etc., in order to study the 25 petabytes of data that comes out of those detectors every year. The data that comes out of those detectors, most of which we're mainly familiar with, protons, neutrons, etc. But occasionally, there are very interesting and remarkable particles that are recognized, most notably of which in 2012 was the Higgs boson, which is the messenger particle for gravity, and it essentially finishes the standard model of physics, which is the theory of physics that we utilize today. Just in time for this talk, last week, they announced that they also identified, just last week, five baryons, which are high-energy particles that also build out the quantum model, which is remarkable. This device gives us an opportunity to delve into the unknown and search for these dark phenomena. And so I encourage you, burst your bubble, because the more you don't know, the more interesting life becomes. Thank you.